He drove into Baltimore City in 1983 in a pickup truck. That's the way that many people who had never heard of David Warnock got to be introduced to him through his television commercial that he first aired here in Baltimore as a candidate for mayor. But there's a lot more to this man who has also co-founded a public charter school in Southwest Baltimore called the Green Street Academy. He is working as a, he'll tell you about the businesses he's been involved with, but he wants to be the next mayor of Baltimore, and I wanted to ask him why. David Warnock joins us in studio. Good morning, David.
Hey, it's great to be with you. Yes, I really did drive into town in that pickup truck. That is the pickup truck.
But the question, you still, now we saw you in a truck in a commercial. Is that still the same truck? You
that
still
is got the same truck.
Okay.
That is the same truck. I put more money in that truck
to keep it
for the campaign. I think it's like $3,500 than I paid for the truck in 1982.
Well, that's love. See, that's loyalty and love both together there, David.
But you know what? That truck is a symbol about not forgetting where you came from. Not forgetting where you came from. I bought that truck. My dad had to co-sign for that truck. I bought that truck because it was the only one I could afford, right? And, you know, when you have a truck, you got a friend. And I've got lots of friends that borrow that truck over the years. But it is. It's become a symbol of not forgetting where you came from.
Let me ask you about why you want to be mayor. You know, a lot of people running for mayor have political experience. They've got several political offices they've held in the background. You don't. And I think you're kind of looking at that model of being an outsider running for mayor. Why do you want to be mayor?
Well, we're at a crossroad, you know, and Baltimore's given me the everything that I have. I am incredibly optimistic about the potential of this city. But it's time for change. The politicians in the race just simply haven't gotten the job done. And it's just time for change. I feel that everywhere I go in the city. I'm a business person. I've taken on challenges that people didn't think could be accomplished. Green Street Academy, restoring the old 91, Grins Falls Middle School, Center for Urban Families. I've taken on challenges in the public sector and the private sector that people said couldn't be done. Put my money where my mouth is on families and children in Baltimore. And I believe that we need a business mind in City Hall because we've got we haven't had an audit of our municipal functions since William Donald Schaefer was mayor. But more importantly, it's time to create jobs and opportunity for people of this great city.
David Warnock is here in studio, candidate for mayor on the Democratic side of the ledger. He is, as you heard him talk about, a Chevy pickup truck driver that came into town. Let me ask you about your private sector background, because you don't have political background. We have to go by that. What is your private sector background? What have you done in the business world that you think merits that you should be mayor?
Well, I came to Baltimore in 1983, worked for T. Rowe Price, and left and started my own business in 1995. You know, I have strived and been successful at taking opportunity and turn it into reality. And I think that that's what's really important in Baltimore today, is taking opportunity and turn it into reality. I've been involved in a number of companies that people in Baltimore know that we've made and employ literally hundreds of people in Baltimore. Town Park, the valet parking company, the Calvert Homeschool, where Barack Obama went to homeschool in first, second, and third grade. Blue Rhino, the propane tank company for your gas grills, are all companies that my venture capital firm has backed, and we've grown and we've employed hundreds of people in and around the Baltimore area with those companies. And I'm very proud of it. And it's given me the opportunity to build teams and address problems and, frankly, do things that people didn't think could be done.